Now, Geraldine Jennings has arrived. She's running a workshop on researching your family tree. That'll be in the Millmount Governor's House starting next week, I think, and also the following week as well. Okay, we'll join her. Interesting. Any questions you might have? Have you started the process? Are you in the process of starting? Yeah, don't know what to do? Well, we got all the rules, got all the sort of ways of helping you get through it as easily as one possibly can. Anyway, if you have any questions, 53958. That's our text number. Or you can phone 1850 715 958. And if you have a specific question, come welcome to LMFM.
Hi, Dara.
You're running workshops on researching your family tree in Millmount next week. I think there's the following week as well, isn't there?
Yes, it's actually a follow-on from the introduction course that I give. I do a morning and an evening course, an introduction to doing your family tree. And this one is focusing more on the technology of it. What do you do with all the information you have? Where do you put it? And then what do you do when you go online? Where do you go? What do you look for? What do you believe? Because we know that not everything online is true, and that is very true for family tree information.
Well, I said this is going to be an empirical interview. In other words, we're going to talk about you and about how you started. A few years ago, you decided to retrace your family history. What inspired you to do this?
Well, it was less an inspiration than an accident. About 6 years ago, I had an accident and I hurt my leg. And I was laid up for a while. And well, cutting a long story short, in the last 6 years, I've been either between being laid up in bed or in a wheelchair or on crutches. So I've had a lot of time in front of my computer. I am an IT consultant by trade. I teach computers in my past life, and then when I couldn't get out, I started looking at this. We had a history of looking at our family tree on my father's side of the family, and when I started researching more and more and getting the documents online, I did a lot, obviously, because I was in the wheelchair. I did a lot online, and then I started researching deeper and deeper.
Most people would probably they'll probably have a grandfather or a grandmother. Some have great grandfathers. Then it gets a bit foggy, a bit nebulous then, doesn't it? I mean, you have to go back to parish records or to census forms, the 1911 and sometimes the 1902 census forms. Yeah. could help.
Yeah. The thing what I say to people is, and I don't mean to be terribly flippant about this, but the dead will always be dead. Concentrate on the living. Don't start rushing back to the dead. That information isn't going to change. It actually will get better. You'll get more information as time goes on, online and things like that. Start with your own relations, with your family. Start with the interesting stories that people have to tell. Yes, well and good, do look on the census. That's one of the easy things to do online. It is true what's on the census for the most part. So it is information you can trust. You can trust certain sites, you cannot trust other sites.
Where did you start? You had this accident, it made you immobile, you had time on your hand, I don't know if you were at home or in hospital, but you had the resources, you had the inspiration and you had the enthusiasm. And you had a lot of time.
I had a lot of time. And what I did with my time was, for the most part in the beginning, I wasted it because I made a lot of mistakes. And that's where I am, if you like, my greatest knowledge is got from mistakes. Wasting time, trusting things on the internet, going down the wrong road. But again, having so much time, I found some really quite interesting stuff. Missing relatives and then finding out why people went missing.
Talk to people who are still alive, obviously. Get
yes.
the stories. What was the biggest mistake you made that people, you don't want other people to make if they're doing this family tree thing?
Trying to go back far too quickly. Trying to see how far back I could go.
Well, you see, yes, yeah. I thought, yes, I can yeah. snap
it's
at you there.
It's not
yeah.
a race. It's not a race. What I did do when I got control of myself, and because it's very exciting. When you start, it can be very exciting. And you think, oh, I'll go back and I'll see who his father was and his mother was.
Yeah.
And then it becomes frustrating because it becomes very difficult to do it after a few generations, and especially in Ireland. We have a dearth of information in Ireland. So what I say is, fine, when you get over the initial impetus to go way back, stop and come back to your parents. Start with your parents. Start with yourself, but start with your parents. Find what is their story. Where do they come from? Not only do you want their address, but now with maps online, you can see what the place was like around them. Looking at the census, not just looking at the dates and names in the census, go into the other forms in the census. They'll tell you about who owned the house that your family lived in, what were they doing, what were they working at. There's loads of information.
Go to the graveyards where they're buried, because if there's one of the family buried there, there's probably a few more that you didn't know about.
Exactly. And that was very much brought home to me when I went to Glasnevin Cemetery and I found the grave of my great-grandmother. I get quite confused with my great and my great-great or my great-great. But this was my great-grandmother's grave, which we didn't know was there, but through a search online, I found it. Then while I was there, I asked somebody a favour. I said, could I just have a look at the book and see who else is in there? And they said, well, we're not busy. We'll have it. Let you have a look.
What's the book?
It was the register of graves. Who's in the graves?
Yeah. That's in Glasnevin, yeah.
That's in Glasnevin. Mm-hmm. And when I looked at it, my grandmother's uncle, who we could never find, I could never find, there was a story told about him, but the truth was he was in the grave. He had died when we had all thought he'd gone back to America. So I began to realise, don't trust what you're told. There are reasons why people might make up stories about family. And the problem was he had died of TB, which wasn't a thing people boasted about. So instead of saying that the poor man had died, leaving his two children orphans, they said he had deserted them and gone back to America.
Your grandfather had an interesting story as well.
Yes. Now, I knew a lot about his story, but just basically that he had been at the Hoth gun running.
At the what?
The Hoth gun running.
Yes, 1914. Yes, this is prior to the rebellion. Yeah.
That's right. Now, he was actually in the Dublin Metropolitan Police.
Is this the Ashguard ship now, is it?
That's it, exactly. Yeah. Now, he was in the police and he was told...